10 Nelson, your community access television. Programming on this channel is made by local volunteers. If you would like to be a part of your community television, please call 354-4200 or write to Shaw Cable, 613 Ward Street, Nelson, B1L1T2.
So long ago, there was a beautiful place where people lived with decorum, elegance, and grace. Sounds nice, doesn't it? Everything was designed to perfection so that only the most graceful people could climb the ladder of success. The dictionary definition of graceful is elegant in proportions or movement, slender or lithe, courteous, charmingly expressed, pleasing, attractive. Ah, yes, life was competitive, challenging. Complex, intricate social standards developed in home, in schools, in business, on the streets. The definition of acceptable social behavior became very clear, and the graceful culture was rich in its conformity.
Thank you.
So, this question of grace was a little tricky. How graceful did you have to be? What happened if you weren't born graceful? Well, according to the laws of that time, everyone had to take a grace quotient, or a GQ test, at an early age. Now, those who scored 70 or above had to take the test again every year. Those who scored below 70 were considered clumsy and never got to take the test again. The dictionary definition of clumsy is awkward, ungainly, lacking in refinement or elegance, tactless. Sounds pretty scary to me, doesn't it to you? I mean, you can see how graceful I am. But back in those days, they would have called me clumsy. Now you see, the arbitrary grace quotient scales didn't simply measure clumsiness, they defined it. Grace and clumsiness meant what testers said they meant.
GQ testing office, where you will take the most important test of your life to determine your grace skills quotient. Now just relax. The test is timed and consists of two parts. First, I will ask you a series of questions. Then, you will make your way through the physical grace obstacle course. When you have finished, you will go back to your seats, and I will give you your results as soon as they have been tabulated. Any questions? Good. Now, there's nothing to be nervous about. Just remember that your performance will affect the rest of your life. Okay, first, Ervin Taylor.
Yes.
Your name?
Ervin Taylor.
Is your shirt inside out?
Yes, it is.
Have you ever cut yourself shaving?
Lot, yes.
I will now clap my hands in a certain pattern, and I want you to repeat it exactly.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever burnt the toast you were making for breakfast?
Just the one I burned for supper.
Mm-hmm. If you got on a bus and went west from here, where would you end up?
Calgary?
Mm-hmm. Well, Ervin, your time is almost up. Better get on with the physical grace course. Just follow the course. Hold on a minute. Just follow the course. Try not to knock anything over, but hurry.
Okay.
This way?
Oh, flippin' thing. Flippin' thing, anyway.
Clara Hancock? Your name?
Clara Hancock.
Do you brush your teeth in the dark?
No.
Have you ever tripped over your feet?
No.
I will clap in a certain pattern, and I want you to repeat it exactly. Mm-hmm. Well, that was all right. Do you have trouble putting the peas on your fork?
Yes, I do. They fall onto the floor, and we make pea soup.
Mm-hmm.
Good soup.
Do you know the way to San Jose?
Nope.
Clara, you also have just enough time to make your way through the physical grace course. Just follow the course. Try not to knock anything over. Go!
Uh-oh.
Stick a tag on 'em. Who are you? What are you? What can you do? What can't you do? What can you do? What can't you do? Stay away, way, stay away, way, stay away, stay away, way, stay away, way, stay away. Why are you strange? Why don't you change? Why can't you change? Why don't you change? Why can't you change? Why are you strange? Stick a tag, tag, stick a tag, tag on 'em. Stick a tag, tag, stick a tag, tag on 'em. Who are you? What are you? What can you do? What can't you do? What do you do? What don't you do? Stick a tag, tag, stick a tag, tag on 'em. Stick a tag, tag, stick a tag, tag on 'em.
So, quite a fair and thorough test, eh? How do you think you would do? Would you make it as a graceful? Or would you have to spend your life labeled clumsy? Well, as you might expect, the clumsies didn't have an easy time of it. In every area of society, they were an embarrassment, objects of ridicule and scorn. Clara here went home and tried her best to fit in with her graceful family. But for her, like for most clumsy kids, things were tense.
Newspapers and a nice sleep.
Yes,
staff.
Mother.
Pay attention. Uh-oh. I can't stand it.
Well, I can't help it.
What am I going to do with you?
I don't know.
I'm so frustrated. That's it. I'm sending you to school for the clumsy children. Get out of my house.
So, Clara. So you were packed off to clumsy school, huh?
Yeah, I was, yeah.
Okay, well. And did you ever get to go home again?
No.
Why not?
I learned how to be clumsy.
Oh, you learned that at clumsy school?
Yeah.
Oh, how to be clumsy. Well, were you a good student?
I was an angel.
Ah.
I'd like to go to class.
In a minute.
Clara, what's the meaning of this? Why aren't you in class?
Yeah.
Don't get smart with me. I'm the principal of this school, and I'll just... I don't know what I'll do if you keep up this behavior. How dare you?
I'm going to class.
She's going to class.
I'm going
to
class.
Yes, Clara was an angel, all right. But in spite of her strong spirit and feisty nature, she had a hard time. So did other clumsy kids. This is what usually happened if a clumsy kid went to the neighborhood playground.
Hey, look, there's a clumsy kid. Hey, clumsy kid,
What are you doing here, huh? Why don't you go back where you belong? Clumsy, 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 clumsy.
So much for clumsy kids. Often, at an early age, kids like Clara and Claudia began to have strange dreams.
Been underground too long. We have done our work. We are many and one. We remember when we were human. We know what a boot looks like when seen from underneath. We know the philosophy of boots. Soon, we will invade like weeds, everywhere, but slowly. There will be no more boots. Meanwhile, we eat dirt and sleep. We are waiting.
People slowly began to develop social consciousness. Small groups sprang up all over the land, designed to assist the miserable clumsies, to help them to become more normal. After a while, some ambitious graceful people pulled together all the groups to form the National Association of Graceful People for Clumsy People.
I call this meeting to order. This is the first official board meeting of the newly formed National Association of Graceful People for Clumsy People. I would like to read our proposed statement of purpose for approval. The National Association of Graceful People for Clumsy People was established for the purpose of helping those less fortunate than ourselves to improve their quality of life. Our goals are as follows. 1, to foster an understanding in clumsy people of appropriate behavior so that they will more successfully blend into our society. 2, to provide instruction in all important social skills such as table manners and appropriate dress. 3, to employ graceful workers who can model appropriate behaviors. Any discussion?
Well, I think it will be so nice when clumsy people can better fit into our society and be less conspicuous, don't you think?
Yes, I agree. We must help them.
All right. The statement of purpose is approved as read. Now, what can we do to help clumsy people?
Well, I'm really interested in social skills training. I would love to teach table manners. I mean, it's so disgusting the way some of them eat. Have you ever seen them in a restaurant?
Why, yes. And the way they walk, they're always tripping over their feet.
why don't we start a series of grace skills classes to teach them to walk properly and dress appropriately?
Oh, yes, I would love to be in charge of that.
And to teach them to talk quietly, become more graceful. Let's establish transformational therapy sessions. Louise, would you like to organize that?
With pleasure.
And my own brainstorm, which I'm very excited about, is to give clumsy individuals an opportunity to, well, to come with us into our homes, spend time with us. What a chance for us to, what's the word? Modeling, positive modeling. I call it the Adopt a Clumsy program. What do you think?
I think it's a great idea.
Would you be willing?
Well, I'll have to check with my family first, but sounds okay.
Yeah, me too. I'm not sure.
All right then. Let's think about that further for our meeting next month. And if there's no more business, this meeting is adjourned.
And so, moved by heartfelt sincerity, the NAGP for CP started immediately to implement its new programs. Barb, with great enthusiasm, decided to start with the Clumsies just on the other side of the tracks. Now, she knew of a home where several adult Clumsies lived, including our old friend Clara. So Barb went, introduced herself, and arranged to join them for grace skills at dinner.
Oh, good evening.
Hi, Ervin. How are you doing there, boy?
I'm hungry.
That's what's up.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our very first grace skills class. Tonight, we're going to work on table manners. And I would like for you all to use your very best table manners so
what's
that you
for dinner?
Can be
I'm starving.
Less conspicuous when you eat in a restaurant. Now, as to your question, we are having spaghetti.
Oh, spaghetti!
And Ervin. Now, Ervin, let's start with you. Before you eat, let me see you take a drink of your milk. No, Ervin. First of all, when you're drinking, take small sips like this. Let me show you. Never mind. And when you're coughing, cough like this. Can you try that? Try that. Oh, that's pretty good. Yes. Keep practicing. Norma. No. You see these utensils? We use these for eating. Now pick up your fork with your hand. Place it into your spaghetti and twirl.
She's a yo-yo.
I'll just ignore that statement. Now, maybe that's a little too much. Oh, I think you can manage it. In it goes. That's it. Now chew it up. That's it. Good. Norma, that was completely unnecessary. Clara, you are a breath of fresh air. Everyone have a look at Clara. She is just a model student. Look how well she's eating. Why, she's almost graceful.
Oh, wow, Clara.
Oh, Clara. Never mind. The use of your fork and knife is exquisite. You know, you are doing such a fine job, Clara. I'd like you to have dinner at my house. Sometime. Keep
Oh, wow, Clara, you're going to eat dinner at a graceful person's house.
She's a yo-yo. She got the best of the boundaries.
I think so.
Thank you.
So, Clara did pretty well this time. Got a little approval. She decided that maybe cooperating might work okay for her. Maybe this would be a turning point. Meantime, what about clumsy people out in public? We take you now to a popular restaurant.
Mind you, I've been very busy myself. I've hardly had a chance to miss you. It's one meeting after the other. You know how it is. It just goes on and on and on and on. And
can I sit down?
Yeah. Do you know this person?
Yeah. Norma, how are you doing?
Charmed.
Yeah, me too.
I did charity work at the church.
Oh, you've done charity work with those people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, me too.
Tell me about your trip to India, Louise.
I went
to
Castle Rock.
It was wonderful. I gave $100,000 to Mother Teresa.
Oh, please. How grand. That's terrific.
I have a friend who's a nun.
What did you say your name was?
Norma.
That's nice. And what is it that you do?
What do I do?
Yeah.
Well, why are you asking me that?
Well, you must have some worthwhile projects that you're working on.
Well, maybe I do, maybe I do. I mean, you know, why do you want to know what I do? I didn't ask you what you do.
Well, I'm sorry. I was just trying to include you.
People are always
you.
Asking me what I do. As you can see, clumsy people didn't really fit in anywhere. But they kept trying. They knew if they could just be graceful enough, maybe they could escape their shame, their fears. They've been struggling, doing their best for such a long time.
Underground too long. We know this system, the intricacies of change and choice. We are adept at turning in all directions, inside out and upside down. There is a great hunger down here. Can you feel it? Can you hear the mutterings? The sighs and cries. You want to go to the surface, but you are afraid. So you stay in the darkness, underground. Shall we wait a little longer? Dig deeper, eat dirt, and sleep just a little longer.
clumsy people became all the rage in Graceful society. Proliferation of new programs emerged in business, in government, in private groups. Helping clumsy people became institutionalized. Once a year, each clumsy person had a big meeting with the NAGP staff and all the grace workers involved. Now, this meeting, called the Educational Program Plan, or EPP, thank you, was designed to give the clumsy person an opportunity to hear everyone's opinions of him and their plans for him in the coming year. I'll sing you all a song about a wondrous program plan. The agencies employ it every day, every day. It's the perfect way to run the lives of those less fortunate, and maybe in the end they'll have a say. It's the EPP, no one gets to say a lot, except of course for me. And when it's over, we all know just what you ought to do. Don't let us catch you trying something new. The plans aren't arbitrary, they're written to improve the person who will be jammed into the mold, in the mold. It's impossible to change them or even to refuse. You've got to do exactly as you're told. It's the EPP, the EPP. No one gets to say a lot, except, of course, for me. And when it's over, we all know just what you ought to do. Don't let us catch you trying something new.
So, Ervin, you should take a bath every day.
Says who?
I'm just trying to help you.
I don't want to be your friend.
Well, but that's all we want, is to be your friend.
I don't want your help.
Well, I don't think you have much choice, do you?
No, you don't have a choice.
Well, stay on my case, will you?
Don't you want their help?
No.
But why not?
Because they tell me what to do.
Yeah, but don't you think they really care about you?
No.
You don't?
No.
Well, how do you feel about that?
I feel like there's cops everywhere.
Cops? Ooh. Well, listen. Maybe you won't run into any cops on the ferry ride. Okay? Grab a chair.
Okay.
Mountains and beautiful seagulls and birds.
Oh, gorgeous. Just a beautiful day.
Hey, there's Ervin.
Oh, you're right. Hi, Ervin. Oh, nice day for ferry ride.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Oh, to Creston.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so are we.
Yeah.
It's a gorgeous day.
Yes, it is.
I don't know if you should be out on your own now.
Did you take your pills today?
Did you take yours?
Well, I don't know. How's your blood pressure?
It's good.
Yeah?
Does a grace worker know where you are?
Do you work with the Ministry of Human Resources, the Remains?
He shouldn't be out on his own.
No, I agree. I think we should call the grace office as soon as we land.
GP marched on. The president's new Adopt the Clumsy program was ready to be tried.
Clara has been invited to have tea at Barb's house with the NAGP board. Oh, Clara is so delighted. She knows this is her big chance. If she can just be graceful enough, maybe these people will like her, will accept her into their circle. This could change her life.
You know, I'm feeling a little nervous about Clara coming over today.
Well, I think it will work. Mm. I think Clara's an excellent choice for our Adopt a Clumsy program.
Yeah, so do I, actually.
It'll never work. Clumsy people should stay with their own kind.
Oh, think positively, Louise. Come on. Oh, that must be Clara now.
Yeah, it is. Hi, Clara. Come on in.
Oh.
Ouch.
Sorry. Uh-oh.
It's okay, Clara. Don't worry about it. It happens to the best of us. So, Clara, have you met Louise?
No.
This is Louise. Louise, Clara. And this is Kim, the president of the NAGP for CP.
Hi, Clara.
Now, would anybody like some tea?
Yes, please.
Good. Right here. Thank you. You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Uh-oh. I'll help you clean up your mess.
Here, at pastry. Pastry and
yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
There you go, Clara. Oh, Clara, let me help you with that. The washroom's just down the hall. Ooh, yucky. Clara's all over my home.
Excuse me, can I have a cup of tea, please?
A clown, but where's that anger going? The hurt down deep inside, is it eating you up, chewing at your pride? Still the anger's in me, I'm trying to forgive. Everyone ignores me, I just want to live. But what am I doing with frustration and this hate? All I want to find is some peace of mind before it's all too late. It takes a special kind of person to look down deep inside, to look behind the veil you find and see what's in your heart. It takes a special kind of person, and that might know it's you, to let people see you believe in me. Show them what I can do. Show them what I can do.
How to live. We know complexity, hypocrisy, compromise, longing. We remember when cut in half, not to bleed or need the other half. We know longing. No more. No more the camouflage of night. We want the light. Look up. Rise up. Push up into the open air, into the light. We have been underground too long. We remember when we were human.
Well, the NAGP for CP had one more program to try. The Graceville classes were mostly chaotic. The Adopt a Clumsy program created a larger rift than there had been before. Something was wrong, but most graceful people didn't care to figure it out. Barb didn't give up, though. She volunteered to keep working, to implement the transformational therapy program. She gave it one last shot, and it worked. Watch for the transformation.
Hello, Clauia. I'm going to teach you to walk just like me today. Won't that be great? Now, the first thing we need to do is get you standing up straight. Now, straighten up. Nice and straight, like this. Okay. Let's go to the legs. Now, let's put your legs together. Oh, together, like this. Oh. What am I going to do with you, Clauia? So frustrating. Put your legs together, stand up straight. It's not so tough. What's this? You want me to walk like you?
Come on.
Well, you know. Well, it feels kind of awkward, but I'll try it for a minute. Hey, I'm getting hangry. That is kind of fun. Yeah.
Why do you insult me? Can't you take me as I am? Slings and arrows, bruised and blunt. Why don't you treat me like a human? Or are you afraid of the secret you might find? That I'm trying hard to love you, trying all the time. It takes a special kind of person, and that, my friend, is you. You don't have to be an epitome. All I want is you. It takes a special kind of person to battle against the odds, to right the wrong, come and sing our song. Someone just like you. Someone just like you.
It takes just one person to make just one step toward change, and before you know it, everything is changing. Barb was transformed into a person who could accept, even appreciate, differences, and she set about the risky business of telling people about it. Before long, graceful families were welcoming home their clumsy relatives. Grace workers began to realize that everyone, whether graceful or clumsy, deserves to make their own choices and to be treated with dignity and respect. Now, we all know the world today is not perfect. But at least we don't have to wear those signs anymore.
You know, I think we should have some clumsy people on the board of NAGP for CP.
What? You gotta be kidding. I mean, that would never work.
Well, why not?
Well, but we don't know how to involve those people at this level. I mean,
well, you know, it is their lives we're trying to change. Don't they deserve to have a say?
But I don't know how to communicate with those people. Would they understand what I have to say?
Of course they would. Well, they are human beings with feelings and needs, just like you and me. In fact, I've become really good friends with a clumsy person.
So today's the big day. I'm so excited. I'm actually really nervous about it. You know, I haven't seen my sister Clara in over 50 years. Well, I told you about that day my mom kicked her out. Oh, it was terrible. And, you know, it really made me cry. But I've never seen my sister again since. She was sent off to clumsy school, and that was it. I hope I recognize her. Gosh, that could be her. Clara?
Yeah.
I'm Alberta.
Hi, Alberta.
Hi. And this is your niece Heidi.
Hi, Heidi.
And this is Alexandria.
Hi, Alexandria.
Clara, it is so wonderful to have you home again.
Do what you want.
I will do what I want.
Sure, if I can call you if I need help.
That's the deal.
Had on the road in Vancouver and in the East Kootenays, and we're very pleased to present to you tonight, right now. Okay, we're going to start this part of the show, and I need to point out that these people will be participating in classes in Trail of Nelson, and we want to start by singing a song which I bet you all know. So if you do, sing along with us. We'll have the house up a little bit so I can see who's not singing.
Chance.
You know?
Waiter! Here, please.
Waitress, oh, you went on the bus. You went on the bus.
Thank you.
You went on the bus.
Hi, I'd like spaghetti and some milk, please.
I had one already.
Spaghetti and milk, too, please.
I had one already.
Hi, Lorraine.
Hi, Sally.
Sally, over here.
Oh, hi.
Hi, how are you, Sally?
Good. Yeah. That's good. You know what? The most ridiculous thing happened to us when we came in this morning, this lunch hour. That person over there asked us to sit with her. Can you believe it?
And I said, no way. I want a nice, quiet lunch. There's no way I want to put up with any nonsense today.
Really?
You know, just no way.
You guys, she's my friend. I think I'll go sit with her.
Hi, Lorraine.
Hi,
Sally. How you doing?
Good.
Oh, you got to have friends. The feeling's oh so strong. You got to have friends to make that day last long.
Sarah has been here. So, we'll go now directly to the triumph group, setting up for their skit. Now, I can talk to you and tell you all about something. So, what would you like to know? Any questions? Anyway, I know we have questions. You chose this. And this is our marker. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
An egg salad sandwich and a chocolate bar and a small Coke that's $4.25, please. Okay, thank you. There's your change. Enjoy your lunch.
Okay, we've got couple hamburgers here, two large milk, some fries.
Wait a minute.
Can you tell me, are these French fries made from real potatoes?
Yes.
They are.
Yes.
You're absolutely sure.
Yes.
Okay. And salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper is on the table.
On the table. And what about serviettes?
They're on the table.
On the table.
Okay, so we've got
hamburgers. Can I have another cup of coffee, please?
Yours is 1310 coffee.
1310, okay. You got the wallet, Joanna?
Okay.
I'm sorry. Okay. Make that. Oh, wait a minute. Cups of coffee? Wait a minute. I've got a dime in my pocket here.
Okay, so
there you go.
Okay,
do you have any real cream?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Okay. 13. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Just pour it in. Great.
There's a pot of coffee we need made back.
Okay. Yeah. So, is that everything for you?
Yep.
Okay. So you've got a hamburger and a Coke, 3 1/4.
Here.
$50 bill. Don't you have anything smaller?
No, I'm sorry, I don't.
It's only 3 1/4.
Just give me my change.
I don't know if I...
Okay. Who hired you here anyway?
Okay. 4, 10, 15.
You're trying to rip me off?
No, I'm... oh, God. What? I'm sorry. There.
Thank you. Ew! My lunch is ruined! Help me! Over here!
Oh, hang on, I'll grab my bucket.
Oh, what?
Oh,
Jeff, are you okay?
Come on over here. Come on over here.
I'll take care of you. Come on with me.
We've got room on the fine smelling mess we've got here. Let me tell you a story. Last summer, my boyfriend and I, we went out boating. And on the way back from Kootenay Bay, I was really kind of feeling adventurous, and I had my hand on the gas, right, and we were rooming out of there. And I said, let's not go home to Buffalo, let's go up the lake a bit. And he says, well, I don't know, I don't think we have enough gas, we've been to Grey Creek. And I said, trust me, we've got enough gas. Yesterday, we went all the way to Grey Creek, down the lake, and we made it back to Buffalo. So we up the lake, 10 minutes out of Riondale. We run out of gas. We're sitting in the middle of nowhere, right? And I look around, a couple of paddles, one of them broken. Have you ever tried to paddle a motorboat?
No.
Oh, not like a canoe, eh? And I'm looking across, no boats. Woodbury's over there. If we start paddling, maybe we'll get there by breakfast. And I'm having visions of hurricanes and capsizing and hypothermia. And I'm saying, well, we just gotta make it around that point, but let's stick close to the edge, eh? And I'm paddling and I'm getting panicky, and I get around the corner and I see a boat! And I step up and I yell, help! 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 We're running out of gas! Save us!
excuse me. I remember I have an appointment.
Thank you.
weren't sure about that one. Okay, we would like to end our show tonight, as we always do, by singing the Light and Power Theater Company song, World Sign, New Chorus. Now, I know that there are some of you out there, Della, and Barb, and Sierra, and Chris, others who know this song and would like to come up and sing it with me.
Hi, Marga.
Marga's going on. Come on now.
Come on, Chris.
Ready, everybody? Am I pitching this?
Of course.
Yeah.
Am I pitching this? Okay.
A handshake?